What is going on, YouTube, man? It's your boy Jay, and I'm bringing y'all boys another by the thumbnail and the title. I'm bringing y'all boys how to become a better shooter in NBA 2K22. So I'm gonna be showing you guys my badges, but if you guys want my jump shot, make sure you guys get me to 22k subs. All right, if you guys want my jump shot, make sure you guys get me to 22,000 subs. And if y'all boys want my drippy face creation, let me know down in the comments below what video you guys want next, how to do couple speed move, how to combo up this, that. Just let me know down in the comment sections below. I got y'all boys. Without further ado, let's just get right into this panger, man. And everybody hit that sub button, hit that like button, bro. Let's get to 22,000 subscribers, bro. Let's go. Alright, y'all boys, so the first thing to becoming a better shooter in this game, right, the first step to becoming a better shooter in this game is having that shot IQ, right? That's number one, having shot IQ. Now, as y'all boys can see by the gameplay over here, that we do win this game. This is a very intense game. So if you guys actually want something good to watch, this is actually a very, very intense game. So we do win this game right here, but the number one thing to becoming a better shooter is do not overkill. All right, don't overkill this year, because people could get blitzes, bumps very, very easily. So it's very important not to overkill. That's why I use a 4-for-4 jumper. So that's very, very important to not overkill. So that's the number one thing, do not overkill. Now, the second thing you need to know to becoming a better shooter is stop playing with no boost. You need to have boost. Like, you know what I'm saying? You need to have boost. Must have boost this year, right? It's just like every 2K, you need boost. Don't listen to those people who don't have boost. Now you need boost this year, right? It's very important to have boost. See, that's a good shot right there. I just missed. See, that's only 12%. I just missed that. Not gonna lie to you guys. But either way, we're gonna keep on this going, this gameplay. We're gonna keep on with this gameplay. You see this guy. He shoots, he misses. All right, we get the board. I think this game went down for a pretty long time. I'm not gonna lie, bro. So he made that, bro. But we do catch up. We do catch up in this game. So the next important thing right here, bro, you don't need Deadeye Hall of Fame, all right? Deadeye this year, there's blinders, there's mismatch maker, there's all these badges and stuff like that. As you guys can see, boom, I didn't overkill right there, and I greened it, right? And there's sniper, bro. Sniper is really, really important this year. There's stop and pop, all these badges. And when you quick stop this year, what I would do is I would not do the quick stop from last year. I would do the same quick. I would do a let go of everything quick stop. Like, you got to just let go of your whole remote and just quick stop. I feel like that's the best way to quick stop this year, because it's way faster. It's way faster. I don't quit. You guys can see in my stream, I don't quick stop like I did last year, like while moving. You know what I'm saying? I quick stop this year, like, literally without, like, I literally just let go of my whole remote and I just click square, alright? That's the best way to quick stop right there. But what I would say is, don't force the threes. There's no showtimes this year, so it's very, very easy to get cold. So what you guys would want to do is basically just take the twos when you're there. But if it's just you and the lock, you could easily kill the lock, like me right there. Look at that peak. That's 4-for-4 speed. Look, that's only 6%. If that was 3-4, that would have been over 20%. So try to find a good 4-for-4 jumper. I'm not gonna lie, my 4-for-4 is really, really good. So if you guys need that, get me to 22,000 subscribers and we'll go crazy. All right, the next thing that you guys need to do to becoming a good shooter is being confident, bro. All right, being confident. Now in stage, it's way harder to shoot in stage. Look at that peak, clean. All right, in stage, it's way harder to shoot. You're gonna need a better, I think the sliders are higher, so you're gonna need more IQ. So if you guys want to honestly become a better shooter, go play some stage and then go back to the park, and you're not gonna miss a shot. Like, you're literally not gonna miss a shot. If you do that in park, like, park is easy to shoot this year. So maybe take the jumper to park, then pro am, then to stage. And then if you start missing the stage, just keep playing. All right, play on the 500 court so you don't lose that much BC. And then start upgrading your courts. That's what I did in the beginning of the year. But yeah, stage is way harder to shoot this year, so it will definitely help you become a better shooter. Another thing is, as you guys can see, I made that shot. That's a good shot. I'm gonna tell you guys why. The percent was like easily pretty good on that shot. But I'm gonna show you guys my badges. I'm gonna show you guys my badges. I'm gonna show you guys talk about each badge and things like that. All right, another thing to become a better shooter is definitely your overall, right? It's definitely your overall. What you want to do is you want to get your player maxed out to a 95. You go to micro, do the micro glitch. Also, you could do other things like overall glitch. You could play park to your 99, something like that. But make sure you get to 99 or 98. You don't want to really be a 95 to 96. 97, okay. Reasonable, but you know what I'm saying? Look at that shot. Wide open peak. Wow. All right, but yeah, 95, 96, 97 is all right, but 98, 99 is where you really want to be at, and your shot, you'll be faster as a player, and your shot will go in more. I just wanted to go to the offense part real quick. Hold on, I'm gonna just show you guys some clips. So as you boys can see right here, look at these clips. Look at me just getting open, and I shoot my, look, I overkill this player. I have that shot right there, but they both jump, right? They both jump and you just peek, all right? Now I'm gonna show you guys my badges. All right, I'm gonna show you guys my badges. All right, so here are my badges real quick. All right, I'm gonna teach you guys what every badge does and what everything does. All right, so blinders become unfazed by a defender from the side. So basically it's Deadeye, all right? So if the person is on your hip, you know, last year that would be a contest. So this year, you could easily shoot that with blinder. So if the person on your hip with a 4-4-4 speed jumper, do not be afraid to shoot. That's very, very important. Do not be afraid to shoot. The next thing I'm gonna show you guys, that I have it on bronze, just to add that little boost to that sniper, because I don't really need no other badge. So I just have Deadeye bronze. Then I'll go Green Machine Hall of Fame is a must. You know what Green Machine does. You guys know what Hot Zone Hunter does. Then we got Sniper. This badge is probably the best badge in the game right now, bro. I did not know. I used to have Chef over this badge, but no. I thought Chef was like limited range, but it's basically fading, right? But Sniper is so tough, bro. Sniper is one of the best badges in the game. You could literally in people's faces. It's like Deadeye on, Platinum. That's what Sniper is, bro. Deadeye on Platinum. And then you got Mismatch Expert. It's shooting over a bigger person than you. So basically lockdowns, centers. So imagine 1, 2, 3. Why would you need Deadeye? Because all these three things are basically Deadeye. All these three badges are basically Deadeye on like Deadeye on an energy drink, bro. Like, it's crazy. Like, all right, and you can't really get ankle breakers this year. You just gotta learn how to move. So you know what I'm saying? So 1, 2, 3, really, really good badges. All right, then we got Stop and Pop. It's a good badge because it boosts your shot rating on standing 3 points after you dribble. So that's why I don't quick stop. Really, I let go of everything, as I was saying before. I let go of everything and I just shoot, and this badge pops up every time. All right, this badge will pop up every single time. That's another reason why it's important with this badge. All right, so now I'm gonna go to my playmaking badges over here. We got Floor General Hall of Fame, Quick Chain. It makes your dribble moves faster. Quick First Step, Handle for Days. I'm talking, you guys know that. And then Hyperdrive. It doesn't make all your dribble moves faster, but increases your ball handle too. All right, and it makes you like combo up faster. So yeah, those are my badges. If you guys want my jump shot, make sure you guys get me to 22,000 subscribers, and I'm off this.